The Holy Spirit has a tremendous sense of urgency right now. So what can I do except to continue to follow along with this? It seems to, it's saying, don't delay, don't delay, don't delay, don't delay this way, don't delay this way. Now, two main themes to start out with here. First, I was driving this morning and wondering what's going to happen, what's going to happen. Suddenly, a rock hit the top of the vehicle. Wham! It seemed like a rock. It was something very hard, like a rock. I didn't ultimately see what it was, but it made a very large boom. That's never happened to me before. Secondly, I'm in this place where these people are unloading concrete, and I'm parked next to them, and I say, hey, do you want me to get out of the way? They say, yeah, you're in our way. So I said, I'll go real fast. I went real fast and then took off, and then they started throwing concrete where I was, you know, rocks. And then I had a third, which I can't quite remember what it was. It's very similar. Like, hurry, 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 get out of the way, get out of the way, get out of the way. Rocks are on their way. Now, of course, a rock sounds very much like Iraq, right? Iraq. Some people might even pronounce it Iraq. Iraq, some of them do. Iraq, Iraq. So maybe there's something going to happen in Iraq. Possible, right? Don't put anything past that place. I wouldn't be surprised at all if some double impact. Again, double impacts are being indicated. Heavy double impacts of some sort. Now, the other good news is that woke up this morning, asked the Holy Spirit for a practice, and the Holy Spirit gave me this practice, says, I am now. I am now. And began to develop this practice, I am now. And I did a tremendous job at this. It's later in the day now, and I'm sort of tired, so I'm not quite as adamant as I was earlier. But what I'm getting to is I had this amazing, miraculous experience take place when I'm doing this. I am now. I am now. I don't need time. I am now. I don't need a world. I am now. And I went saying, I don't need whatever it is. I don't need anything at all. I don't need even consciousness. I am now. I am now. I am now. And I really got it. You know, I really I got the practice. I mean, I was doing it very, very well. So I drive up to this place, and there's this dog that's there. We've seen it a number of times. Every time I get out, the dog is just barking like crazy. It's one of those dogs that, you know, there's a fence, it's in its yard, and it just loves to bark and bark ferociously at anyone who's there, and just keeps going and keeps on and keeps on, like it's protecting its territory, you know. One of those types of dogs. And so I said, oh my God, not this dog again. And so it started, and you know. And the idea came to me, hey, let me just start practicing this I am now and see what happens, okay? So I started again. I am now. 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 And within a few moments, actually, it was that fast, the dog went stone cold quiet. And then I said, finally I looked over and said, what happened? And the dog was just like wandering along, smelling stuff, going like I wasn't even there. Now, the dog had never exhibited this type of behavior to anybody before. It was like it wasn't even aware I was there. Before, it had always been, you know, rabidly, you know, one of those rabid dogs that just chased like it wants to bite you, you know. And it just stopped. As soon as I started practicing, I am now, it stopped. And just wandered around like wasn't there. So I'm saying, wow. And you talk about a wow, there's a wow for you. This practice, I am now, the way I did it this morning, was extremely profound. And I really understood, I really experienced what it was getting at, what it meant. Of course, I cannot explain it to the satisfaction of the intellect. You have to practice and experience it yourself to know what we're getting at here. But I highly recommend it. At some point, You know, this is something that is available to us. This practice, I am now, I am now, is like the, so it's almost like the dog is I wasn't here. It sidestepped the ferocity. You see the ferocity of the world that the Holy Spirit seems to indicate is coming. It didn't touch me. Suddenly it stopped. This dog was ferocious, and it just stopped, stone cold stopped, as if I had somehow disappeared and wasn't even there. I am now. I don't need any future. I am now. I don't need any past. I am now. I don't need any story. I am now. And I went on and on and on and on and on and saw each one of these ideas was suggested to me and then put in the format. I don't need, you know, this. I am now. I don't need any place. I am now. I don't need any person. I am now. I don't need any world. I am now. It only really resonates when you're really into this practice, adamantly and focused on it, and you do it sort of slowly, whatever suggests itself, and then you'll find that more and more and more and more and more you can practice this way and really feel that I really don't need this at all. I am now. I don't need anything. I am now. I don't have any needs. I am now. I don't have any needs whatsoever. I am now. I don't need concepts, I am now. I don't need a story, I am now. I don't even need a life, I don't need a life, I am now. I don't even need awareness, I don't need awareness, I am now. See, I am now, I am now. This is where I am now. What else could I need? I don't need anything else, do I? I don't need anything to be added on, I am now. I don't need anything subtracted, I am now. Now, I delayed a little bit later on in the day, and I got this feeling like that was a bad thing. I said, I wonder if something bad's going to happen from this little delay, and son of a gun, if this big truck didn't come and try to block me. And I had to get around it somehow. And I said, oh my gosh, I wasted like 20 seconds. If I had not wasted that 20 seconds, I would have been gone before this truck was there. And so I realized the Holy Spirit was telling me, hey, don't mess around right now. Don't go look for glittering stuff right now. Don't. And I took it to mean, don't be digging into graphics right now, because that can be a big delay. I mean, you can start looking and looking, and before you know it, days and days and days and days have gone past, and the Holy Spirit says, right now, you can't do that right now. It's super go time for some reason. It's super go time. So you get up in the morning and a rock falls on your vehicle, you know. I mean, it's like, what is going on here? Is it a space rock or is it a rock? You know, I don't know. You know, hit 100, 104 today. It's been 102 plus every day this week. But you know what? I felt like today, oh, so mild today. What happened to the heat? I thought the heat was coming. It's 104. What? We're getting used to it. This is what it is. We're getting used to it. It's amazing. After a couple days, you know, the third day is not so bad. Fourth day is like you feel, oh, this is kind of mild. It really feels mild right now, but it's not. It's not at all. I think it's still over 100. I am now. I am now. I don't need space. I am now. I don't need time. I am now. I don't need process. I am now. I don't need form, I am now. I don't need progress, I am now. I don't need learning, I am now. I am now, I am now, I am now. Align, 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 align. It feels like this practice is the key to some sort of ascension, or some sort of sidestepping. Where that dog gave me the key, where it was as if I suddenly had disappeared, and the dog wasn't even looking at me. It was just wandering like there was nobody there, completely out of character. So it was as like I had disappeared, somehow spiritually. I am now somehow in time, where that what the dog was perceiving, somehow I didn't exist there. Now, of course, when you're going about your day-to-day functioning and you meet so many people who are in their intellect, which is really continuity fear, you know, your practice is going to lag a little bit. But in the morning when I woke up and I was getting into this without any interruption, boy, was I really into this and doing it very, very well. Really feeling it, that, you know, this is, I can feel the importance of this. I can feel the intensity. This is just great. I don't need any tomorrows. I am now. And I got the feeling of what it's getting at. So this is a great example of a true spiritual practice. And of course it bypasses the intellect entirely. When the intellect is nothing but continuity fear, actually. The intellect is nothing but continuity fear. And continuity fear will dress it up, you know, make it look important and everything, but it's nothing but continuity fear. It doesn't understand spiritual practice at all. And this is why we can be stuck in our intellect for a long time, and we may seem very spiritual, like we know a lot, but we're not practicing. Which is the goal, of course, of the intellect. The continuity fear is the goal, and the continuity offers intellect, says, you don't need to practice, you got this intellect. This intellect is so smart, it can figure everything out. You know, what do you need practice for? This is why the continuity fear develops, has this, you know, intellect that it tells, this is what you need, you know. You don't need anything else. Once you have this, it'll give you all your answers. You know, what it's for is blocking spiritual practice. And it certainly blocked it for me for a long time. A long time. You don't need to do that stuff. You know, you're smart enough to figure it out. But it's all continuity fear. All of that. When you really do spiritual practice, it's profound. You feel that there is a great profundity to it. Even though you're nervous and frightened a little bit, you may not feel much results, but you still feel like, wow, this is really, you know, getting at it. Wow. I am now. This is my identity, that I am now. I don't need any interpretations. I am now. So is the problem going to be Iraq, or actually, you know, Iraq, space rocks come in, or what's exactly? But there is no question that there's some subtle guidance that is pointing out that there's a great need for her to expedite preparations of some type. And be very much on point now. Now, the least I can tell you is, if someone suggested that this practice, yeah, I am now, and said, you know, if you come to this place of refuge here, we can do this practice, I would say, okay, for sure. I could see how this works. I really can see how this would be profoundly helpful to us. So I don't know how much practicing we do, but it doesn't really matter. I know that this is part of the tools that we can use. Very simple practice. Not an intellectual practice to be figured out, but it's something to be affirmed with determination and faith. I am now. I don't need existence. I am now. I don't need any dreams. I am now. I don't need any outcomes. I am now. I don't need any thinking. I am now. I don't need any reactions. I am now. I am right now. That's what I am. I am now. Right now is what I am, actually. And so just the ability to be aware that there is this practice and to practice it, this puts us in a much higher level of discernment than we were before, previously. Now, if you were to say that someone who's guided by the intellect, which is really continuity fear, you know, I am now, they'd say, oh, okay, I got it. Yeah, you're saying you're now. Okay, I got it. The intellect will say, I got it. And that's it. And then say, okay, nothing more to see here. This is what happens when you're guided by the intellect, emotion, reaction, personality, egoic complex. It's really the continuity fear complex. A defensive system, continuity fear, defensive system. It says no need to practice, you know, no need to, just intellect has it, it's got it, it's filed it, it's cataloged it, and that's all that needs to be done. And now next, you're moving on. This is the trouble, isn't it? So people simply don't practice it. This, you know, spiritual practices aren't difficult at all. It's what happens is that we allow the intellect to block us, saying no, don't need to do that. It's a waste of time. I already got it. I understand it. I understand what it's getting at. Yeah, I got it. And you're there, kind of saying, well, wait a minute. I don't really feel like I've got it. I don't really feel like I've even practiced it at all. And the intellect says, no, it's not important anymore. Not important, don't waste time. I got it. So this is what happens, unfortunately, in the world. That this is very few in the world actually practice. Most just intellectualize it. As did I for a long time. But it's an entirely different situation when you actually practice. And it's not difficult. The ego tries to say, wow, that's only for really advanced, you know, people, wow, it's just so advanced, it is so difficult, you know, if you try to do that, you're going to go crazy, it's going to cause problems, you'll have a breakdown, wow, that's not true at all. It's not even remotely true. The ego always tries to scare you away from practicing in one way, you know, it's just got all these various ways of doing that, diverting us from practice. So we just say, I am now, I am now, I am now, I am now, I am now. I am now. I don't need anything. I am now. I don't need anything. I am now. I don't need anything. I am now. intense. So you have to get used to the wow of this. What's important to know is that we do have the awareness now that we have this tool. I am now. And just practicing that, like with an enlightened teacher, holy cow. You know, let's not make any excuses. That's going to have some tremendous effect, maybe even dimensional effect, actually. If you just keep asserting, I am now, and adamantly, I am now, I'm only now, I'm just, that's it, there's no, just I am now. What effect is that going to have? I don't need any sickness. I am now. I don't need any wellness. I am now. I don't need anything at all. I am now. I don't need a body. I am now. I am now is our true identity. I am now. I don't need I am now. I don't, like I said, don't need consciousness of I am now. I am now. I don't need anything telling me I am now. I am now. I don't need any symbols. I am now. 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 I am not any of this continuity fear play at all. I am now. Always have been now. Full stop in the wow. Don't strain to try to think of something to practice. When you start practicing and you have the energy and you're adamant about it and you're doing it, you will find that many things occur to you to say. To practice, you say, "Hey," and it gets better and better and better. And you think, "Wow, I don't need this. I am now. I don't need that. I am now. I don't need time. I am now." I don't need thinking. I am now. I don't need recognition. I am now. I don't need any place. I am now. I don't need anything to happen. I am now. I don't need anything to happen. It's very important. I don't need anything. I am now. I don't need anything. I am now. I don't need anything. I am now. Now, this is the ever-loving gospel truth, the great good news, and we can practice this. Nothing better than a heat spell. Weather-wise, once you get used to it, then it feels so nice, so nice. Then a little breeze comes out. Oh, it's beautiful. It's just the first, you know, few days. Everything seems very still, peaceful and still. And it's like you can smell the earth, smell everything. It's all, you know, you feel like it's not separate. You know, everything is not separate. Somehow it seems to give a feeling of oneness better. We say everything is feeling the heat. Now this is a weather type of heat, but not the psychological agitation that the world is cooking up. That's not a good thing. You don't want to get used to that. I don't need anything. I am now. I am now. I don't need anything. I am now. I am now. I don't need anything. I am now. See, I am now doesn't need anything in order to be, right? You know, I don't even need to be. I don't need to be. I am now. I don't need to abide, I am now. I don't need to be awareness, I am now. I'm even greater than abidance, you know, consciousness, awareness, I am now. I just am. It's the isness of reality, the isness of it. I just am. And I am now, I am now. I am now. I don't need anything. I am now. I don't need any place. I am now. I don't need any place. I am now. This is very powerful. I don't need any place. I am now. I don't need any place. I am now. The Holy Spirit is very, very adamant right now. I was thinking of like going doing something after work today. As soon as I thought that, I turned to my left and I was in traffic and I saw this truck and there was this advertisement on the truck and it basically said, stay at home. And it's like, whoa, you know. And it's like the answer became immediately, you know, stay at home. It was adamant. Stay at home right now. Don't be going out doing anything right now. Wow. No graphics, just tape, practice. I don't know. It's amazing. I go to the store to get some stuff for my diet, and everything that I want is, my diet's on sale. You know, it's a great sale. This stuff is ridiculous. As I said, I'm on this diet. grapefruit juice was on sale, like a dollar off. Fage Greek yogurt, on sale, a dollar, almost a dollar off. And then they had this great kale, Brussels sprout salad, you know, spinach, kale, Brussels. And then, you know, it's a spinach and with greens, that was off too. So everything from my diet was like on sale. Great savings. Interesting, great savings. And they continue to lose weight. Awesome. It's been about, come tomorrow, maybe it'll be like 2 weeks, you know, diet where I will get lost at least 10 pounds, I would say, in 2 weeks. Almost a pound a day, not quite. But that's a great way to, we have momentum going into this next news cycle. Now, when I talk about a news cycle, keep in mind the original 9/11, that started a news cycle, didn't it? It started a news cycle, and that cycled through the wars, you know, the Iraq war, the war in Afghanistan. It cycled through, you know, all this turmoil, all this political turmoil. It was horrible, right? I mean, how long did that cycle go along? A long time. And we're just, you know, just feeling like maybe, you know, we're out of that cycle. Well, how it happened was, once we just thought we might be getting out of that cycle, 9/11, 2008, Lehman Brothers declared bankruptcy, and suddenly all the financial instruments suddenly start collapsing. Institutions went poof, like smoke and mirrors, gone. Bear Stearns, I think, Lehman Brothers. And we had the terrible recession. That was horrible. It was so scary. You're thinking that, you know, you were going to be out of work. It's a funny thing. We had a lot of work during the recession. Once the recovery happened, that's when we don't have work. Very strange. Maybe it's a fake recovery. I don't know. But so on the 7th year anniversary of 9/11, we have the recession, that horrible 2008 recession, which, you know, is still reverberating. I mean, Europe has had a terrible time. A lot of countries there, you know, are in austerity still, very badly. Greece just recently, you know, gone into an extremely terrible situation. So the stock market, I don't know what it's doing now. I stopped watching. I really don't know. But I imagine it's still volatile. It started getting very volatile. And so here we have the second 7-year period. 14th anniversary. What's going to happen on that anniversary is the question. It seems as though the Holy Spirit has got this practice to me. I am now. Just before 9/11, the 14th anniversary of 9/11, and experiencing this dog suddenly going quiet. So somehow it shows that this can protect you from agitation, because that dog was a real nuisance. I'd say, shh, go quiet, dog. No, it would bark all the more, you know. You try to, shh, I'm okay, dog. You talk to it. I'm not bothering you, dog. I'm okay. How are you, doggy? Rah, rah, rah. You know, it makes it even more agitated. But say, I just practice silently. I am now. I am now. I am now. I am now. Silent. So right before the 14th anniversary of 9/11, the Holy Spirit brings in this practice, I am now practice. I am now practice. You see, this is different than a book about I am now, or words about I am now, whatever, or explanation about I am now, or anything like that. This is brought in the practice, because I actually practiced it. This is very, very different and very significant. And I experienced the power of it. The power of I am now practice. Actual practice. I am now. I don't need anything at all. I am now. I need not, absolutely not even the slight, tiniest little bit of anything I am now. So I would say it's extremely significant. And then getting this video, I think the Holy Spirit wants this video up before 9/11, so I'll get it up. What time, how much time we have in there? I can't see it. The sun is hitting so bad. It's I still can't tell. Let me see if I can get past the sun here. Okay, 40 minutes. Okay, 40 minutes of this. And I want to get it up to, I don't know what. What is that? It's almost already 40 minutes, so. But I want to get up on the internet, YouTube, before it hits 9/11. Of course, it's already hit in some places in the world, actually about 5 o'clock. It's now in China, and in the East, it's already the morning of 9/11. So maybe I should get it up on YouTube right now, so it's available. Yeah, that's a good idea. Let me do that. Let me not wait. Holy Spirit's given extreme pressure to, you know, do it now, do it now, do it now, do it now. I am 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 now. Okay, we have the tools. The practice has been done. It's been understood, the power of it. And this has something to do with our safety, our sanctuary. Okay, it most definitely does. From the severe agitation that is likely to become in this next news cycle. 9/11, the first news cycle. Then the recession on the 7th anniversary is the next news cycle. And then 7 years later, I believe, the next news cycle is going to happen quite soon. And this may take us, you know, into just unbelievable amount of agitation. I'm not going there, and I suggest nobody else go there either. So let me get this up on YouTube, and so at least you're aware of it, that we have this tremendous practice. I am now. The I am now practice. I don't need anything. I am now. 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 And believe it. Say it with faith and conviction. Adamantly, this is true. I don't need anything. I am now.